There are many different theories that can be applied to different films. For example, the theories of the likes of Todorov, Levi Strauss, Baths, and Prop. In this vlog, I will only be discussing Todorov and Prop's theories. So Todorov believes that there's a five-part narrative, which consists of an equilibrium, a disequilibrium, a recognition of a disruption, an attempt to repair the disruption, and a reinstatement of the initial equilibrium. So if we start with a state of equilibrium at the outset. Batman hasn't really been seen for 8 years. Crime rates are really low and everything in Gotham is safe due to Harvey Dent's act on crime. There's a disruption to the equilibrium by some action. Bane fights Batman, breaks into Batman's armory, imprisons Batman and takes control of Wayne's nuclear reactor. So a recognition that there's been a disruption. Bane blows up the bridges surrounding Gotham, so there's only been one exit from Gotham which Bane controls for supplies and protection that no one leaves the city. Bane alerts the world of the situation and the fact that he controls a nuclear bomb which will detonate in a matter of months. There's now an attempt to repair the disruption. So Batman escapes the prison and returns to Gotham to stop Bane and save the city. Batman finds Bane and starts a war between Bane's army and the police force. So then there's a reinstatement of the initial equilibrium. Batman defeats Bane and his men and flies the bomb over the bay so the city is clear of the blast radius. The bomb detonates and the city is safe. In my opinion, Todorov's theory does not work with Batman Dark Knight Rises because like most modern films, the story is too complex. There are too many characters and side plots and defining moments in the story. The structure would work for the film if it was describing sections of the film rather than the whole story. Prop believes that there are 8 characters: a hero, a villain, a donor, a dispatcher, a false hero, a helper, princess, and a father. The hero is Batman, or Bruce Wayne, in the savior and protector of Gotham. The villain, Bane or Miranda Tate. Bane does the bidding of Miranda Tate, who you could argue is a true villain. The donor, Lucius Fox, heads Wayne's research and development program in Wayne Enterprises and designs Batman's vehicles, weapons, etc. The dispatcher, John Blake, a police officer who believes in the Batman and knows his true identity. He tells Bruce that Batman needs to return. The false hero is Miranda Tate. Is trusted to take control of Wayne Enterprises and she betrays Bruce as she's really working with Bane. The helper, John Blake, Selina Kyle, Commissioner Gordon and Alfred. The princess, Miranda Tate. Batman sets out to save her but she turns out to be a false princess as she's really working with Bane. And there's the father, Ra's al Ghul. He makes a brief appearance in the film when Bruce is in the prison. Ra's al Ghul is the leader of the League of Shadows and father of Miranda Tate. He taught Bruce everything he knows and Tate wants to fulfill his destiny of destroying Gotham. Prop's theory or structure to the narrative side of the story works better than Todorov's in my opinion, because instead of telling events, which limits a description of modern day stories as they are so complex, it describes characters and depending on how much detail you go into your descriptions of these characters, you can begin to narrate the story a lot better than you can using Todorov's structure. Although you could argue that Prop's theory resembles a cast list. Whilst being better than Todorov's structure, it still has its faults. Today's stories are more complex than the simple structures these two men have devised. Sometimes, in modern stories, the characters could overlap each other. For example, using Prop's theory to tell the story of The Dark Knight Rises, Miranda Tate is a false princess because she also turns out to be a villain. Thanks for listening, and leave any comments you have below.